Hi, in my previous video, I have already made a 3D scan of this cylinder jacket, but the valve cover is not removable and I have to scan the valve seat using the single line. It doesn't give me a high detail and the precision required for reversing.
So I will reverse engineer the valve first and then I will use its profile for cutting into the valve seat.
Because the valve has three angles, one defines the thickness of the valve, one is the valve angle, and the last one would be the back off angle. So there are three angles that I need to measure. I'm not intending to make a modification to the engine. I'm not the engine expert. I try to preserve the original design as much as possible. So these two valves share the same size of the valve stem, 9.35 mm. Okay, this will be the intake valve. Yes, this will be the exhaust valve. It's flush, this one, the exhaust. The intake is not flush, higher than the valve seat. And it has like indentation here. In a modern engine, the combustion phase of the valve is flat. This one is curved. I really don't know why they put this. So if someone knows, please put it in the comments. It will be a very good insight and education for us. In my last video, I used the X1 to scan for the cylinder bore, and the markers are on the table, so it's about 20 or 30 centimeters from the scanner. The further the distance that is away from the scanner, the lower the precision is going to get. Bore diameter of the engine is critical. There's two ways that you can measure this. One is by using a bore gauge, place cylinder jacket on a mill finish table, very flat, and then use the bore gauge to probe it. You cannot use the vernier caliper to measure the internal diameter of the cylinder because it's going to give you like 100 or 120 microns of the error, and the single line laser from the X1 is going to give like 30 microns of the accuracy alert. It's not as precise and accurate as the 7-line or the cross line. 7-line is the most accurate scanning mode with this scanner because the camera is placing closer to the object. But I couldn't use the 7-line to scan this the whole jacket because I cannot put the markers on the object. It has a lot of finale. I'm going to scan just the top part of the bore using a 7-line laser. Maybe I can go about 2 or 3 centimeters deep, and I'm going to place some of the marker along the edge of the hole so it will be closer to the scanning phase. When the marker is closer to the scanning phase, it's going to give you the highest precision. Sometimes when you see striking lines, that is because your marker is too far away from the scanning phase and it's giving you a precision error. Okay, so I will scan the bore diameter using the 7-line laser, and I need to place the marker closer to the scanning phase. It will give higher precision. This is a magnetic marker that I made a year ago. So if you haven't seen this, this means that you are new to this channel. Okay, this will be the cylinder jacket that I scan with a single line, and this will be the scan from the parallel line. Let's bring this into AutoCAD for measuring the diameter. Okay, it's in AutoCAD. The yellow one is from the single line and the green one is from the parallel line. So I'm going to find the center
of the circle first. Next, I'm going to draw a circle. So this will be the circle. This one from the parallel lines. Let's check the roundness. Lead line is the perfect circle. 100 microns out of roundness. About this half of the cylinder is 100 microns out of roundness. The one from the parallel lines, it's a lot less. It's only 50 microns. Parallel line it's give a higher precision than the single line because number one, as told you before, the marker is very far away when I was scanning this. But this one, the marker is very close to the hole that I was scanning. So this will give a higher precision than the one that scanned in a single line. And there's a chance that the manufacturing defects or wear of the cylinder liner, it can give a oval shape of the cylinder, but it's considered to be small because it's only start to getting out of the roundness, only this area of the cylinder. So let's check the diameter. So the dimension is different. And if you come to the wiki page of the Indian Power Plus, this is the same engine that I'm reversing. Is 79 millimeters, 3 1/8 inch. If I convert it to millimeter, it's going to be 79.375. The scan data from the parallel line is closer to this number than the scan from the single line. So this cylinder bore is 80 microns larger than the specified value. This could be from the wear of the cylinder. I'm going to use 79.4mm for the bore diameter of this engine.
Okay, next I'm going to make a 3D scan of the intake valves. And I've put 3 markers because I'm going to make a 3 scan. 1 and 2 and 3. This marker is to identify the alignment when I align the 3 scans together. Place the valve in this orientation so I can scan the valve seating angle and the valve stem in a 360 degrees. And this is a high precision part. I'm going to use the X1 and I have already scanned this with the S1. I'm going to compare the result after this scan. The S1 tracking performance and scanning speed is very close to the X1. You can't feel the difference when I switch from S1 to X1. Because I'm going to scan with the parallel line, I want the highest accuracy. So I need to place the marker closer to the valve stem. So the scanner will track this tower instead of the marker that is very far away. The closer the marker to the object, the higher the precision it can be. So the rule is simple. And the scanning tower has a triangle shape, so it won't be blocking the valve stem when I scan it. And I'm gonna place it just a little bit here. I use 0.2 for the resolution. Okay, I'm going to turn this side up first. I will emphasize on scanning the combustion phase. I'm gonna turn this, put it down. You should fill it before you crop it because you could delete the markers that necessary for
doing the fusion. Next, I'm going to align them together using a marker alignment, using this first scan as a fixed window and the second scan as a float window. So I'm going to click on the marker. That easy. Okay, now 1 and 2 is aligned together. See here, we need the third scan to seal this edge of the valve. It's missing. Item. Okay, now we have defects from the extreme edge of the scan because you don't need this. I say 0.5. Okay, on the left is the X1 and on the right is the S1. There is no way that you can spot the difference between these two scans using the mesh for comparison. They all look the same, but you can see a small faint of the overlapping area on the S1. It has about 30 a micron a lower precision than the X1, and it can cause this faint seam line.
45.11.
I make a thin cross section, and then I'm going to show you the difference. X1 is on the right, S1 is on the left. If I turn on the measurement here, you can see that the dimension from the X1 has no accuracy alert comparing with my 10 micron step vernier caliper. It reads same value every time, 45.11, so it has the same accuracy error as my 10 micron step vernier caliper. But for the S1, the dimension is different. It's 35 micron larger than my vernier caliper. It's in the range of 50 micron accuracy error. If you use the X1, you're gonna get a tighter tolerance. And the difference number two is that the S1 has less precision, so it's going to give you some geometry error if I draw a line. Okay, you see the bump? The bump on the corner here is not supposed to be a bump here. This bump is wrong. It's from the precision error. And here's from the X1. There is no bump. The difference is not much. Majority is the accuracy from the X1 is higher. Because it will be the aligned point cloud exactly the center of the origin. Because the scan is very clean, I don't need to do any adjustment or decimeter. I'm going to create a profile for revolving. Revolve it. Axis. Okay, so this part will weigh 156 gram. It is made from steel.
152 grams. So the original part is 4 grams lighter.
And I think I know that why they put the indent on the combustion phase. I think they use it for spinning so that the valve will run in with the jacket. I think this is the contact phase with the valve seat, and they use this indent for spinning. Thanks guys for watching. See you in the next video.